God. Lord God, we just thank you, Lord God, for your presence, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for your spirit, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for who you are. Lord God, we rejoice in the fact that we have life. We rejoice in the fact, Lord God, that we have breath, Lord God, that you woke us up and you gave us another chance, Lord God, to do your will and do your purpose, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Lord God, just create in our a heart, Lord God, of worship, creating us, Lord God, a heart, Lord God, to do your will, to do your purpose, Lord God, creating us, Lord God, and change us, Lord God, change us, Lord God, in your image, change us, Lord God, to be more like you, Lord God, change us, Lord God, so that, Lord God, that when we come to you, Lord God, that you don't see none of our flesh, Lord God, but you see your spirit, you only see you, Lord God. Lord God, I just thank you, Lord God, that you're dealing with our hearts and our minds, Lord God, about issues, Lord God, that you're causing us, Lord God, to go into prayer more, you're causing us, Lord God, to go into worship more, you're causing us to get more in the word, Lord God, so that we can change our desires in our hearts, Jesus, Lord God, in our mind to be more like you, Father. Lord God, I pray, Lord God, over this ministry, Father. I pray, Lord God, that you just begin to just just grow us up, Lord God, in your spirit, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, that you just begin to change and transform this ministry, Lord God. And Lord God, that you take us to places, Lord God, to our purpose and our destiny, Lord God, through this ministry, Father. Lord God, I pray, Lord God, today for your service, Lord God, for this service. Lord God, we pray that your spirit be in this place, Lord God, that we pray that your spirit, Lord God, go through, Lord God, the person that's speaking, Lord God, the person that's preaching, Father. I pray, Lord God, that they hear what you have to say, Lord God, and they begin to flow in the spirit. They begin to speak to us, Lord God. And Lord God, that we open up our minds and our hearts to receive, Father. Lord God, open up our hearts and our minds to receive from you, to receive the word, Lord God, and to apply it to our lives, Father. Lord God, I thank you, Lord God, for those who coming here that's not safe, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, for their soul, Lord God. I pray for the person that's coming in here broken, Father, Lord God, that's the person that's coming in here, Lord God, with a lot on their minds and on their hearts, Lord God, that they release it to you, Father. Lord God, that they give you their concerns, they give you their worries, Lord God, and Lord God, that they submit their will to you, Father. Lord God, I pray, Lord God, for the increase of this house. I pray for increase, Lord God, of finances, increase of people, Lord God, increase of teachable leaders, Lord God. I pray for leaders, Lord God, in this place, Lord God, to help us do the work, Lord God, that we're called to do, that God's house is called to do, Father. I thank you, Lord God, for the open window of heaven, Lord God, for the increase, Lord God, and the provisions, Father. Lord God, the provision, Lord God, for this ministry, Lord God, so that we don't have to need, Lord God, for anything. Lord God, I pray that you cover Apostle, Lord God, in this time, Lord God, and her family. Lord God, that you cover her, Lord God, and that she won't have to worry about any type of finances, Lord God. Provisions will be made, Lord God. Lord God, that you will send the people, Lord God. You will send the help, Lord God. You will send, Lord God, those things that you need her to send things to the church, Lord God, for the church to do its will and do its purpose, Father, in the earth. And so, Lord God, I just thank you, Lord God, for stepping stones, and I thank you, Lord God, for what you're doing, Father, in God's house. Lord God, I pray, Lord God, over the ministry staff, Lord God, that you begin to just step us up, Lord God. Lord God, that we just draw closer to you. I pray, Lord God, for the members, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, that they draw closer to you, Lord God, and that you provide for them, and you do, Father, and they do your will, Lord God, and they grow and heal and be in this place, and they grow as well, and they go to different dimensions as well. And I pray, Lord God, for those who are sick in our ministry, Lord God, that you heal, Lord God. Lord God, that you heal them, Lord God, of any issues, Lord God, ailments, Lord God. Lord God, that this place be a house of healing, Lord God, and it's also a place, Lord God, of deliverance. Yes, Father, I pray, Lord God, that you know, anybody that's dealing with anything, Lord God, that you causing them, Lord God, to deal with that thing, Lord God. If they have to confess it to somebody, if they have to go through counseling, if they have to do whatever it is, Lord God, that we get through, Lord God, and get delivered, Father.
Yes.
And Lord God, I just pray, Lord God, for those who right now on the streets, Lord God, that don't have a roof over their head, Lord God. Yes. I pray that you cover them, Lord God. I pray that you send people in their lives, Lord God, to minister to them, to give them the necessities that they need, to give them a place to sleep, Lord God, to give them food to eat, Lord God, to give them, Lord God, just basic necessities, Lord God. And Lord God, give them steps, Lord God, on how to change their lives, Lord. I pray, Lord God, for those who are in the hospitals right now. I thank you for those who who are in hospitals, who are in jail cells right now. I thank you, Lord God, that you're comforting, that you're keeping them, Lord. I pray, Lord God, that you're sending us out, Lord God, and to minister to those, Lord God, Father, with no judgment, Lord God, with no criticism, Lord God, but Lord God, that we minister, Lord God, like we are you, Lord God, and how you love on us and how you extend love to us, and Lord God, how you show compassion and empathy to us, Lord God, that we do the same, Lord God, to others. Lord God, I pray, Lord God, that we do that, Lord God, for those who are in the jail cells, Lord God. We pray for even those who are in the halfway houses, Lord God, the same way, Lord God, that people that need prayer, Lord God, that you leading people, Lord God, to that ministry, Lord God, to guide them, Lord God, into you, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, right now for our family, our unsaved ones, Lord God. Lord God, I pray, Lord God, that you use us, Lord God, or use someone, Lord God, to minister to them, Lord God, so that they may serve you, that they may give their heart to you, Lord God, that they may give their mind to you, their time to you, and give their heart to you, Father. And Lord God, and I just thank you for it being done, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, for your presence, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, for what you're doing, Lord God, and I just give you praise and I give you adoration. Yes, and at this time, I'm going to read some declarations from a book called Prayers That Release Heaven and Move Mountains by John Eckhart. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Their declarations, though, as I say them, I just want you guys to be in agreement with me. Amen.
Amen.
It's declarations of the righteous. I will enter through the gate of the Lord. I am delivered from trouble. My root cannot be moved. I choose my friends carefully, and I will not be led astray.
Yes.
The memory of my name will be blessed because I'm righteous.
Yes.
My labor leads to life.
Yes.
I only desire good.
Yes.
My thoughts are right.
Yes.
My house will stand, and I will not be overthrown.
Yes.
I will have a refuge in death and will not be banished.
Yes.
I will walk in integrity, and my children are blessed. I do not covet greedily. I give and spare not.
Mm-hmm.
I am bold as a lion. Mm-hmm. I am not snared by transgression. I sing and rejoice.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I consider the cause of the poor.
Amen.
I cry out, and the Lord hears.
Mm-hmm.
He delivers me out of all my troubles. I show mercy and give.
Amen.
I inherit the land and dwell in it forever. I speak wisdom and my tongue talks of justice. The gates are open to me and I enter in because I keep the truth. I will not be destroyed by the wicked. I will go away into eternal life. My words are like choice silver. My words encourage many. My hopes will be gladness. I will never be removed. My words bring forth wisdom. I am delivered through knowledge. I flourish like foliage, and my roots yield fruit. And Lord God, I just pray, Lord God, that as we declare, Lord God, the prayer of the righteous, Lord God, and declarations of the righteous. Amen.
Amen.
And so let's just give God praise. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. I just thank you. And at this time, I'm going to call up Deacon Cherie to the next part of our service. Amen.
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 Amen. Our scripture reading will be coming out of Isaiah chapter 46, verse 9. That's Isaiah chapter 46, verse 9. And when you got it, say, I got it.
I got it.
Amen. And it reads, remember the former things, those of long ago. I am God and there is no other. I am God and there is none like me.
Amen.
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 Amen. Now let's go into our program, which is on our seats in the upper left-hand corner. And it reads, hear the commandments of God to his people. I am the Lord God who brought you out of bondage. You should have no other gods before me. You should not make for yourself any idols. You should not invoke with malice the name of the Lord, your God. Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. Honor your father and your mother. You should not commit murder. You should not commit adultery. You should not steal. You should not lie. You should not covet anything that belongs to your neighbor. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Amen.
Now let's pray before service proceeds. Amen. Dear Lord, we thank you, O God. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in this place. Father God, decrease us as you increase, Lord. Let your spirit reign and take over on today, Lord God. Open the floodgates of heaven on today, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for just being you and for touching our apostle, Lord God. Speak to her like never before. Continue to pour into her, Lord God. Continue to bring an increase of revelation, Lord God. And I thank you and I praise you. In Jesus' my name, amen. Let us receive the word from Apostle Dr. Martina Way Hill.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
This is a wonderful day in the Lord. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Amen.
I'm in a very reflective spirit. Y'all flow with me because God has really been dealing with me about his will.
Okay.
And if anybody had to deal, had God deal with them regarding will, that conversation might not go the way we think it should go. Y'all still with me?
Yeah.
And so I'm still yet, God is still yet teaching me and still yet molding me. And I thank God because I believe that the preacher should grow just as the people should grow. Amen?
Amen.
So y'all follow me today. Amen? Open your Bibles to Ephesians 5. Ephesians 5, 15 through 17. And I'm going to read the NIV. And when y'all got it, just say, I got it.
I got it.
Amen. Anymore, I got it. Ephesians 5, 15 through 17.
Got it.
Amen. And it reads, be very careful then how you live. Not as unwise, but as wise. Y'all say wise.
Wise.
Making the most of every opportunity because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is.
Amen.
Amen. I'm going to teach today understanding God's will. Mm. Understanding God's will. Dear Lord, help us to understand you more and more through this message. And Lord, even as I'm speaking, please, Holy Spirit, not only surround this place and surround our lives, but be ministering to us individually, be ministering to us corporately, be ministering to people who are watching on Facebook Live and YouTube and Periscope, and begin to speak to them about the will that you have for their lives and for their families' lives and for their church's lives and for the lives in their community, Lord, for the lives of the places that they'll work in and people they'll affect. Lord, it's so important that we are in your will. So, Lord, help us to understand that more and to be willing to submit to your will.
Yes.
And to be able to fall in obedience to what you ask us to do. Yes. So, Lord, we thank you for your spirit of holiness and order. And, Lord, allow our obedience, even though it may not always be easy, let us be willing to be obedient to your voice and to your plan. In Jesus' mighty name, and everyone together with joy say amen.
Amen.
Understanding God's will. All right. So, this we going to have class in session, right? I'm your teacher, Dr. Martina Wade Hill. I don't have a board, but I have a pretend board. So, by the raise of hands, how have you guys ever prayed for one thing and then God gave you something else?
Awesome.
This is a hard thing to explain to new Christians. Very hard to explain. They're like, no, the Bible said that. I don't understand why the Bible said that, but God didn't give me what I asked for, but it was a desire in my heart. He didn't give me. I'm about to teach you a word that we understand very much in our governmental, a word we understand in our governmental, you know, hierarchy in the United States of America. This is a powerful word. We understand. The word is, I want you to repeat after me, veto. There is veto in the spirit.
Wow. Sure.
Wow.
Ouch.
And we're going to learn God's veto today. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, so raise your hand. Have you ever been confused on why God allows certain things to happen and not other things? Okay, you're in the right place. Have you ever been going down a path and then God just switches up your path?
All the time.
You had a future laid out for yourself. You've been going down this path for a few years.
Right.
And then a swift move, your life completely does a 180.
Yeah. Amen.
And everything you thought you wanted, your desires, everything, the people change, and you're even a stranger to yourself. Woohoo! You in the right place. Have you made plans, and then God just gone and changed your plans up, whether it be in a day, for the month, everything? You just, this is how I'm going to do it, step one, step two, step three, and God says, let's just skip to step 10 and rule out all of them. Come on, how many of you ever gone through that?
Amen.
All right, so me too. I've experienced all these things, and I'm going to give you a very spiritual acknowledgement of what I've gone through when I'm experiencing these things. It's very spiritual. It has baffled me. That is a spiritual thing as I can get. I've completely been baffled. Yes, you're a prophet. Yes, a confused one at times. Because you don't understand the mind of God.
Right.
Sometimes it's just easier to obey and figure it out later.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, if you're an obedient Christian, you just on autopilot. I'll just obey. Tell me left, right, I'll go. Yeah. And then when he makes you think, we forget we have a brain.
Right. That's good.
Yes, apostle.
And so we have these moments where God will throw us a curveball, and we ain't quite recovered from the last curveball.
Right.
And we sit here and wonder, I don't know if you've ever done it, I sat there and wondered, what is God doing? That's the first one. Not like, what is God doing? It's not, no, it's really flesh, very human. What is God doing? And then I have these other flesh moments, I'm going to keep it real. Some of you may not have talked like that with God, but I've had these moments like, so you thought this was a good idea, right? Did you just meet me? I know you made me.
Right.
But you actually thought I was going to react a different way to this? Did you saw what happened last time? Why do you keep doing this to me? So I have these moments, these conversations with God. I'm very candid. I think the Lord loves the fact that when I come to him, I don't become in line. So if I'm foul, I'm just foul before God. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
And I'm honest with him, and I think that's why he uses me.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
So I thought I would share with you some tips that could help you understand, the tips that have helped me to understand God's will. And I thought maybe it would help you understand God's will just a little bit better. Amen?
Amen.
Now, I'm not going to lie to you and tell you these 8 tips I'm going to show you. Now I'm going to change your whole life and you will understand God from now until death. Well, no, because understanding God is a journey, and you will leave this life still having questions unanswered.
Yeah.
But I will share with you some things that will bring you closer to God and hopefully closer to the will for your life. Amen?
Amen.
All right, so first tip to understanding God's will is, number one, God's will overrides our plans.
Yes, it does.
AKA veto. His will overrides our plans. So the word override means to overrule a decision, which I think is interesting. Brought me to the time when I was working in retail. And I was working in retail, and it was one of my first experiences in retail. And I'm gonna be honest, retail is not for me. Some people really have a retail personality, and that's not me. So I'm in retail, and I had to make some really powerful decisions based on the fate of a person's phone. And people know that when you're dealing with people's phone, it's like dealing with their firstborn, social security number. I mean, it's their whole life, right?
Yeah. Mom, Jesus.
So I had to make this powerful decision about this person's phone, and my decision was going to be the decision that was going to be made. So I don't remember the decision that I made, but whatever decision was, it ultimately did not make the customer happy. So they went back and talked to the manager, and the manager looked at my decision, and even though they understood why I came to my decision, they weren't mad at me or anything, they really wanted to make this customer go away and go away satisfied.
Right.
So they overrided my decision, and they did something in the system that only required a manager's code.
Mm.
So I couldn't go in there and make those same decisions because I worked outside of my realm of authority. Am I going somewhere?
Yeah.
I worked outside of my realm of authority. So anything else that was gonna get done, it had to be someone with a higher authority that can make those changes that will make sure that the higher ups would listen to them and allow them to make that decision.
Wow. Yeah.
So it made me think about how Jesus goes as the higher authority and tells God about what we need. Y'all still with me?
Yeah.
So we pray and we pray and we ask in Jesus' name so that Yahweh will shift for us. Yeah. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
And so I look at that as some things that we can do in the authority that we have in the earth realm. But some things we just need God to override, to move some things for our behalf. How many things do you think that you might need overrided in your life where you know in your own power you can do, but God can do it for you? Yeah. Amen?
Yeah.
So I'm looking at this situation and I'm thinking about the prayer. Matthew chapter 6, verse 9 through 10. Matthew 6, verses 9 through 10. And this goes with the Our Father prayer. The scripture says, this then is how you should pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That was interesting because all my life, I had not really interpreted this scripture the way I have a scripture that I interpret it now. When it says in verse 10, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. That means that if we pray for the kingdom, then God's will be done. Y'all still with me?
Yeah.
And so I realized when we are praying, Lord, show me your glory. When we are praying, Lord, we want kingdom. We want to take care of your kingdom business, Lord. We want kingdom in our household, Lord. We want kingdom. We want to be kingdom minded. We want kingdom in our churches. We are asking the Lord's will to be done, because when we're asking for his kingdom to come, then we're expecting his will to be done. Right. If you want to be kingdom minded, then you want your mind focused on God's will being done for your life. And so that's what we need to understand. So when we are operating in God's authority, when we are understanding why God makes decisions, we have to understand that when he overrides a decision, it's because he wants his kingdom to come in our life.
Amen.
When we ask God, have your way, we're asking his kingdom to come into our lives. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Number two, eight tips to understanding his will. God's will falls in line with his scriptures.
Amen.
His will falls in line with his scriptures. Our will doesn't.
Sure does.
Our will falls in line with our corrupt thoughts and selfish manners and attitudes and our own dreams and ideas that God laughs at and some he honors.
Amen.
But when we have to deal with God's will, we can open up that Bible and watch, whether it's judgment or blessing, we can watch it scripture by scripture, because he's a God that shall not lie. The Bible clearly says it in Numbers 23:19. Write that down so you remember. Numbers 23:19, the New Living Translation says, God is not a man that so he should lie. He is not human, so he does not change his mind. Has he ever spoken or failed to act? Has he ever promised and not carried it through? Mm. Remember that. So he's not like us, and he's not flaky. He's not going to lie. If God said it, it's going to come to pass. Right. Somebody say amen.
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 Here's the third one. This is really good because it makes me understand that his perfect will falls in line with the promises of the word. Amen?
Amen.
The third one is God's will prepares the way for our promises.
Amen.
God's will prepares the way for our promises. Have you ever been afraid to ask for God's will?
Yeah.
Okay, so here's a litmus test. If you ask for God's will, if you're afraid to ask for God's will, that means that you know your request to him is shady.
Yeah.
Okay? Let's keep it real. If you ask for his will and you feel straight about whatever he do, your heart is right, everything is right, your mind is focused. But if you don't want to ask for his will because you know deep in your heart he gonna say no, your request quest for Shady in the first place.
Yeah.
You weren't wrong. You already knew what God wanted to do. You just wanted your desires over God. You don't care.
Right.
See, let me really help you. Because y'all know y'all been there. Yeah. You want something so bad that you want God to give it to you. And if it don't work, you want him to fix it.
Right. Sure. Yeah. Yeah.
You're like, I don't care, Lord. I want this, please. Oh, Lord, please let me have love. Lord, it'd be like, you know it's flesh. When you straight willing to kick and scream, every prophet done told you no.
Yeah.
And you willing to kick and scream when people tell you not. You done went to the pastor. The pastor was like, I don't think this is for you. Be like, no, I can give it. And you kick and scream and fast to believe God. You done left churches over it. It just, I mean, I've seen it.
Yeah,
I've done it.
Yeah.
You all in it, all about the rebellion, because it's all about what you want. Because you know you wrong.
Amen. Amen.
You know the answer is no or not now.
Right.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
So check your heart. Check your heart. So if God's will, if you can't pray, let your will be done. Hey, you already know what the answer is.
Amen.
You already know. Now, if you're afraid, but you know you want God's will, but you hoping that it's a yes. That's human.
Right.
That's human. But when you just straight up like, I don't care if it's your will or not, just give it to me. You wrong.
Yeah.
You wrong and your heart not right.
Amen.
I had so many situations where I was rebellious in my prayer life. How are we going to go to God and ask for something for him to do this completely opposite of his word? God, please give me him or her. They married. Just give him to me. What? It's the truth. I know people who've done it.
Wow.
We can't do stuff like that.
Yeah.
We can't ask God to do something opposite than the word.
Mm-hmm.
People say, you can pray for anything within his word. He's not even listening to wickedness. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
If you're not sure if it's in his will, look in the scriptures. It will tell you. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen.
All right. Oh, yeah. Turn to 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9. New Living Translation. And you know what? This scripture needs an Academy Award for everybody in here that is waiting on a promise. This one should be like in your car. It should be on your screensaver in your phone. It should be on a wall at home. It should be in your wall of office. Definitely write it on your heart. This right here is the trophy scripture. Y'all ready?
Amen.
The Lord isn't really being slow about his promise, as some people think. Nope. He is being patient for your sake.
Wow.
He does not want anyone to be destroyed, but wants everyone to repent.
Wow.
Oh, amen.
Can you repeat that?
Yes, I will.
Where is that?
2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9, New Living Translation.
Wow.
This is the screensaver if you're waiting. Somebody, raise your hand if you're just waiting for God to do some things. Okay, and you have this look like, God, when? What time, Lord? This is it. Yeah. He ain't slow.
Right.
You are.
Yeah.
Amen.
He ain't slow like some people think.
Yeah.
He's being patient for your sake. God not slow, he patient.
Wow.
So every moment when you think you're ready, God, I'm ready. God, I'm ready. I'm waiting. God, I'm ready. But he's saying, no, you're not. You think you're ready, but you're not ready for the responsibility of it. You're not ready for how this is going to turn out.
True.
That thing ain't ready yet.
Amen.
The timing ain't ready. You might be ready, but the time ain't ready.
True.
You just don't know. God wants to make sure everything is in place when he blesses us.
Amen.
My dad said something to me the other day. He said, God don't just bless in pieces. He give you the kit and the caboodle.
Yeah.
Wow.
He know what you need. How God gonna give you a plate and he ain't got you no fork and knife?
Right.
You know? How he gonna give you a fork and knife and ain't got you no food to cut it? You know? God, he said, he don't bless in pieces. He blesses with the kit and the caboodle.
Amen.
So I remember that God does the whole combo package thing, that he's gonna bless you with the whole package that you need. Because he doesn't want any of our blessings to go sour.
Mm.
He doesn't want us to be destroyed. Neither does he want our blessings to be.
Amen.
So when he gives it to us, he wants us to be a sign of his victory. He wants it where all men know, sit at the table, people looking, feasting while you, watching you be blessed. So they be like, dang, look what God did for them. Surely God can do it for me. That's what he wants. He wants his name proclaimed among the land.
Right.
And it look real busted if your name ain't his name ain't proclaimed among the land.
Right.
So when he blesses holistically, not in pieces. Amen? He don't do no itemized blessings they leave back at the stove. He don't do that. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
He give you the whole thing and got the receipt. Amen?
Thank you, Jesus.
Some of y'all don't know how to pray for his
love. Amen.
All right. So what was number one?
God will override our plans.
Two?
God will fall in line with his scripture.
I got more than one person in this church. Three?
God will prepare the way for our promises.
And we got more than two. Thank you. Amen.
Amen.
Four, or eight tips to understanding God. Four is God's will takes time to understand.
Yeah, amen.
God's will takes time to understand. Proverbs 3, verses 5 through 6. Proverbs 3, verses 5 through 6. New Living Translation says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not depend on your own understanding. Seek his will in all you do, and he will show you which path to take. Okay. First part says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Okay, issue one. Do not depend on your own understanding. If you're confused, that's issue two.
Issue two. Yep.
Seek his will in all you do. If you're afraid to seek it, that's issue number three.
Three.
And he will show you which path to take. So let's look. Let's look. One plus one plus one equals God show you the plan. Okay. So you praying, Lord, show me the way. Show me the way. Lord, show me the way. What I should do. Well, where I should go. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord. Right? Mm-hmm. Pray something like that. Okay. Something like that, right? You have trust issues with the Lord. Because for some reason, we've misinterpreted why God has done things. We've been disappointed.
Mm-hmm.
Bad things sometimes happen to good people, but God works it all together for our good, right?
Amen.
So we got trust issues with the checks and balances of life. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. Fair enough? Mm-hmm. So that first part of scripture is a minus one already in the total. So how many pieces we got? One, two, three, and that's four. Okay, so we got one plus one plus one equals three, right? Mm-hmm. So now we got two.
Mm-hmm.
Next one is, do not depend on your understanding. So we're confused. God, I don't understand why. And we have a hard time seeking him for understanding. Because we have that trust issue. And when you have trust issues with God, him trying to tell us stuff, there's a block right there.
True.
Your lack of faith is going to block you from getting the understanding that you need. So that trust component is really vital if you need God to show you the way.
Yeah.
So if you don't trust him, or you only trust him a little bit, yeah. Or you trust him in most areas, except for this one. And then you're not going to find out what your way is, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then seeking him and all you do, that's the whole thing, that asking your will, Lord. Because we just really want what we want.
Mm.
So all these things that we hide in our... So we say we wait and we wait and we wait and we're mad at God. And we go back to that other scripture and saying, God, I'm waiting on you. I've been waiting on God for 10 years. I've been waiting on God for 5 years. But God has been patiently waiting on you.
Right.
Because you haven't learned how to trust him yet.
Mm.
And so because you haven't learned how to trust him, you're still on your own understanding.
Mm.
And since you're still on your understanding, you're too stubborn to seek his ways because you really want your own way. And because of that, you are still waiting for him to work it out.
Wow. Yeah. Wow.
God is genius with this word.
Amen. Amen.
These are not scriptures that we use separately. They create this wonderful picture of life.
Mm-hmm.
Good, bad, and indifferent. Amen.
Amen.
So, work on that trust issue, and you will find that God will tell you more about his ways. He will tell you more about which way you should go. And we have to work on those healing parts. Here's the thing about trust. We need God to help us trust.
True.
Yeah.
That means I have to give you something so I can get something.
Right.
So the area that's blocking my trust, I have to give you my mistrust. I have to give you my pain. I have to give you all those things. I have to put it down. I have to go as far as lay it down for you to get it.
Right.
Because that allows you to have to come in my heart and fill the gaps out.
Yeah.
And until I do that, I'm never going to get what it is I asked for.
Mm.
And I'm going to keep waiting, and God's going to keep being patient.
Amen.
At least he's still being patient, right?
Amen.
God loves his children, amen?
Amen.
I think about it. A lot of times we get hurt about the checks and balances of life. And I thought about how when I was a teenager, you know, your teen, you're an emotional teen. I don't know, some teens aren't, but I was an emotional teen. And so my parents made a lot of choices for me that I wasn't at that time understanding about.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, you're a teenager between adult and kid. So you're like, I think like a kid, but I look like an adult thing. And so my parents were like, no, you can't do that. No, you can't go there. You can't talk to that friend. You can't. And I'm like, why? You know how we deal with girls are horrible women. Why? So we go through all that. And we're mad at mom. We're mad at dad. And that goes on for some time. And then we get older. We get grown. And we start understanding that at that time we didn't understand. And we thought we were being held back. But then we realized we were being protected.
Yeah.
And we're, oh, they make those decisions to protect me, to protect us, so that we wouldn't be hurt down the line because they were being good parents.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. God did not open that door because he was being a good parent. And as much as you wanted that door open and you begged and you could not see what was on the other side of that door, you could not see what was going down that line, you could not see what was going coming for you 2 years up the road, waiting for you, waiting to devour you, waiting to set you back, God understood. And he said, no, I'm gonna lock that door because I know you. I know you, son. I know you, daughter. I know what I put in you.
Right.
And this situation, this role would damage everything that you've worked so hard for. And all you think is this is a wonderful opportunity, but this just wasn't the right one for you. So if God blocked some relationships for you, he blocked some people for you, he blocked those things, it's because God was being a good parent.
Amen.
And he doesn't want you to be in a situation that will cause you to be unsafe. Because let me tell you, he is your father and we are his precious children.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And we are vital to the life and the breath of this ministry on earth. And God chooses to use us to proclaim his word. And if the word is broken in you, how can you make disciples in someone else?
Right.
So he protects us. Amen. So just say, thank God for keeping me safe.
Thank God for keeping me safe.
Romans 8:28. And I know you guys know this already, but if you don't know it, keep it safe. It's help us to understand things. Romans 8:28 says that all things work for all things that happen for our good to those who love the Lord and who are called according to his purpose.
Yeah.
So if you're struggling with the checks and balances of life, this scripture will help you understand that it'll all work together. I think about food that tastes so good, like you know, like Chex Mix and, you know, those sweet and salty mixes.
Yeah.
It's got salt in it, but it's sweet because it's got the chocolate and stuff in it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's nuts, and it's just yummy snack treat, you know? The salt makes it good. It's not too sweet. It's not too sour. It tastes so good. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I think about it is, even the things that happen in your life that caused you a little pain, it didn't destroy you, but it helped you in the areas that were just so wonderful and victorious in your life. You began to appreciate it. You began to worship God, and you were able to share with others about the decisions you made, good, bad, and indifferent, and it all ended up working good for the good of you who are called to his purpose, because now your testimony are saving lives everywhere you meet, your family, your friends, your co-workers, one person at a time. You're encouraging them. You're enriching them one person at a time. You are even taking your own experiences and looking in the mirror and encouraging yourself and say, I'm not the same person that I am today. God saved me one day at a time.
Yes, he did.
And even today might be a bad day, but God said, I got tomorrow.
Amen. Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Number 5. Understanding God's will. God's will shuts the mouths of naysayers.
Oh, amen.
God's will shuts the mouths of naysayers. So, 1 Peter 2:15. 1 Peter 2:15, NIV. It says this. I love this. For it is God's will that by doing good, you should silence the ignorant talk of foolish people.
Yes.
I'm going to read it one more time. For it is God's will. Y'all say God's will.
God's will.
That by doing good, you should silence the ignorant talk of foolish people.
Amen.
You do what God told you to do. His will for you is to shut the mouths of the vipers. You out there fooling, he's going to let you succumb to whatever you're doing.
Wow. That's true.
Amen.
Yeah, that's true.
Amen.
But if you do what you're supposed to do, it's going to be all victory. All victory. What, you probably asking me, what about when I'm doing good and hell breaks loose? What about then? Ride the wave, walk on water, survive the storm, and then in the morning, the mouths will be shut.
Amen.
The mouths will be shut. We have to trust God in those storms too. Do you understand what I'm telling you?
Yeah.
See, sometimes God just let him talk.
Yeah.
This is good. Did you know that God sets us up for a victory? He sets us up. He'll say, yeah, my son or daughter is going to go through a little hell. Maybe you, 1, 2, 3 years. But in that hell, I'm going to make them strong like steel.
Yeah.
So they're going to be crying. They're going to come to me. They're going to be fasting. They're going to be praying. And they're going to be a little weary. Okay, but I'm going to strengthen them. I'm going to carry them through the storm, but they're going to feel the wind. They're going to feel the rain, but they don't understand how much I'm carrying them because they don't drown.
Yeah.
They don't drown. I still have them because little do you know that you have people there that are envious of how well you're going through the storm.
Right. Right.
They're looking and watching you and expecting you to fall on your face, but you're still gliding through the storm.
Wow.
Even though you're still smiling.
Jesus.
And ministering to people. Amen. And still say, you can do it. You know when God is carrying you through a storm, when someone has lesser troubles than you in that season, and you're still telling them they can do it because they're plugging into you and because you're going through hell, but they have no idea because they look at the strength that's on your life.
Right,
and then
right,
when
right.
you come out of the storm, God restores you. He showers you with blessings, and the same people are watching you and say, man, and then God, what is he do when you come out the wilderness? The Bible said he gave Jesus more power. So he gave more power, more blessings, more elevations in this next season. And what do the naysayers do? They shut their mouths. But you don't even care anymore because you're so tall on that mountain and they're so low in that valley, you can't even hear them.
Come on.
Amen.
God will shut the mouths of naysayers. And I should add, and then he'll make you just not care. He'll make you not care. And the things you used to obsess about and ask God about consistently and drain the prophets about, you don't even care anymore. You don't even care. You'll be like, oh yeah, I used to care, but I don't care about that.
Amen.
Because God has brought you to the mountain.
Right.
And all of a sudden now, you see the picture a little bit more clear. And those little things that used to really irk you, just you don't care about them anymore. Because God has shown you. I think of Martin Luther King who says, I've seen the mountain.
Yeah.
And that's where God will have you. Say, Lord, take me to the mountain. Say, Lord, take me to the mountain.
Lord, take me to the mountain.
And bless me there.
And bless me there. There.
Come on. Come on. Shout for God.
Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Number 6. 8 ways. 8 tips of understanding God's will. Number 6 is, God's will for us is to be holy.
Amen.
Amen.
God's will for us is to be holy. So 1 Thessalonians 4:3. 1 Thessalonians 4:3. It says, it is God's will that you should be sanctified.
Amen.
It's God's will for you to be sanctified. It makes me think about how when God leads me to something and when he has directions for us, he leads us to a righteous life and repentance.
Mm-hmm.
So when he wants us to do something, wants me to go, wants me or you to go somewhere, it's because he wants us to be righteous and he wants us to repent so we can be righteous. And those are the directions that God wants us to go. He wants to lead us to forgiveness. He wants to lead us to healing. He wants to lead us to reconciliation. He wants to lead us to restoration. God does not want one of us, not none of us, to be hurting for too long.
Yeah.
Some pain he understands is necessary for the grooming, for the pruning. He does understand that. But he does not want us to be wounded for too long, because he wants to get the glory for our restoration and healing. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
It's always God's will for us to be whole. Amen. Somebody say, I want to be whole.
I want to be whole.
Number 7. Understanding God's will. God's will makes us thankful.
Yes. Yeah, that's true.
It's so true.
God's will makes us thankful. 1 Thessalonians 5:18. 1 Thessalonians 5:18, the NIV. It reads, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Mm. Give thanks in all circumstances. Does that mean some?
No.
Does that mean some?
No.
That means what?
All.
Say what?
All.
Say one more time.
All.
All right, so when you get laid off, give thanks for what?
All.
Oh, yeah.
For rest.
When you get breakups, give thanks for?
All.
When people lied on you, give thanks for?
All.
When some people lie to you, give thanks for?
All
circumstances. It sounds crazy, people. Mm. Like, boy, I laid off, but give thanks. People are like, yeah. What? You need a job. I didn't say I didn't need a job, just take off. But this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
It is God's will for you in Christ
Jesus.
Jesus.
Yes, yes.
When someone we love pass away,
amen.
We do what?
Give thanks for all.
Give thanks for all. That's hard.
Yeah.
But we know to be absent from the body is to be one
present with the Lord. Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
Give thanks for all. I'm going to tell you this. I need to work on that give thanks for all thing.
Amen.
When I'm having a bad day, thank you, Jesus, don't really come into my heart like that. I'm just going to keep it real. Y'all pray for me, I pray for you, okay?
That's amen.
How we do it. That's how we do it. Amen. I'll be coming to God, and I'll be fussing and complaining, you know. And people say we shouldn't complain, you know. Pray for me, I pray for you, okay?
Amen.
So I come to God, and I'm fussing like, yeah, you know, this and that, you know. And the Lord said to me, after he does, God loves it. He gives me the floor, lets me just vent. And I wait there like, okay, now what? You know? Like, what? And then he looks at me, and the Lord says, but you're safe, though, right?
Wow.
And I'm like, oh, man, don't give me that safety speech. You ain't, you know, you got food to eat, though, right? Yeah. You got a vehicle to drive, though, right? Yeah. You'll be able to live your life unaffected, right? You just don't like how it went down. Mm-hmm. But you're straight, though, right?
Amen.
Yeah. So why are you complaining? I'm like, I'm just, but God, what about tomorrow? I'll take care of you.
Amen.
But God, what about this? Didn't I give you the last job? Yeah, I'll give you another one. Yeah. Okay. Lord, what about that person? Didn't I give you your last friend? Yeah. Well, when I'm ready, I'll give you another.
Amen.
Let me pick them, because I do a better job.
Yeah.
Okay, Lord. And then you got to ask God about picking your friends, because we like to pick, we like our friends to be a certain thing. Mm-hmm. You pick for him, like, I don't usually be friends with them like that. Well, you help them, they help you, right? Come on, somebody.
Yeah,
I'm real bougie when it comes to friendships. I talk to a lot of people. I make you think we're great friends. I go home and be by myself. By myself. I'm the most extroverted, introverted person you've ever met. I guarantee you. I talk to people when I'm out and about. I talk to you. Mm-hmm. When I'm in my house, I don't say nothing. Yeah. I might talk to one person. That's it.
Wow.
Come on, let me call somebody else. Well, I'll call you later. Want me to come up? Well, you, I'm one of those people that I would talk to you all day on the phone, but don't want you to come over. Yeah. We should do a girls' day. No. This is good. This is about as close as I need to. I'm a real funny, acting, introverted person. I am. You, some people are like, are you a gymnast? No. Because I'm very flip-floppy. I talked to Sheree. She's like, you know, if I didn't know you outside church, I don't think we'd be friends. And I wasn't offended. I was not offended. I was like, I do act funny sometimes. Yeah, you do. You really do, cousin. You real funny acting. I'm the type, if you invite me somewhere, I'll go, but I may not talk to you.
Right.
I am that way. Please understand, it's not personal. It's my personality. Guys, that's a possible thing. I was doing that before. I'm just keeping it real. I'm that person. You like, are you having a good time? I'm fine. I'll sit there and watch you have a good time. And when I'm done watching you, I go home.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. God wants us to be thankful in all situations, even our challenging ones. Amen.
Amen.
Here's the last one. Let's start from the top. Number one, everybody.
God's will.
Okay, number one, Sheree. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, Sheree, give me number one.
God's will
over our
plans. Number two, Sheree. God's will cause a line with scripture.
Three.
God's will
prepare
in the way for our promises.
Can we get together number three?
God's will prepare in the way for our promises.
Number four.
God's will take time to understand.
Number five.
God's will shut the mouths of naysayers.
Number six.
God's will for us to be holy.
Number seven.
God's will makes us thankful.
And I'm going to give you number eight. God's will is to prosper us and to give us hope for tomorrow.
Amen.
God's will is to prosper us and to give us hope for tomorrow. Jeremiah 29:11. Y'all know you got that in memory. Matter of fact, everybody's like, yes, yes. That's my scripture.
Yes.
For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. So God plans to prosper us and to give us hope. Isn't it awesome to know that on a bad day, that we know we got more good days coming?
Yeah, that's good.
Isn't it awesome to know that even on a bad day, we had a lot of good days?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Isn't it wonderful to know that? And even if you've had a lifestyle that was very hard and challenging, God still wants you to know that you have a future. And that the best is yet to come.
Yeah.
And that you don't have to stay down. That God has a plan to bring you up.
Yeah.
If you choose to believe him. Amen?
Amen.
We have a good friend in Jesus. And he promises never to leave us or forsake us. And he promised to be with us to the end. And so that means even on those bad days, he still got us. He still won't leave us. And he promises to bring us through. I am so glad. I'm so glad that the Lord has a will for my life and for your life, and his will is to keep us covered.
Amen.
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 Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you and we praise your name. We thank you that you got us covered, God. We thank you that no matter what we've been through, there's still hope for tomorrow, and there's still a future for us, oh God.
Yes,
we're thankful, oh God, that you're patient with us,
yes,
even when we keep
you,
badgering
Jesus.
You about the same stuff, but ain't did nothing you told us to do.
Yes,
Lord, we
yes,
just thank
yes.
you that you are patient with us, oh
yes.
God. We thank you that you called us and chose us and molded us, and we still clown at times. But Lord, we thank you.
Yes.
Lord, we just thank you for your love and your support.
Yes.
And Lord, even when we leave here today, we'll still have questions about your will. But thank you, Lord, for this insight that we don't feel alone, Lord, that you hear our cry, Lord, that you placed it on my heart to share, Lord, about how to understand your will and how to be closer to you, oh God. Lord, we thank you for the insight and for the relationship, oh God.
Yes.
We love you. We magnify your name. And Lord, please don't ever leave us.
Yes.
Please don't ever go nowhere.
Yes.
Lord, a lot of things could happen, but you can't go nowhere.
Yes.
And we just thank you, Lord. And we love you, Lord. In the matchless name of Jesus, we pray. And everybody say, I receive it.
I believe it. I believe it.
And I'm thankful for it.
And I'm thankful for it.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's all the clap you got. You clap for that.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
At this time, the altar is open for anyone who desires prayer.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord. God is good.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I feel a prophetic utterance.
Yes.
Speak, prophet, speak. One of God. Sister Jalicia. God wants to push you faster in ministry. He's going to restructure your life where you're going to give more time to ministry. It's going to change some things around on your job. God is waiting for you to be very clear in your prayers. He says you often say, Lord, I want your will in order to not make a choice. And some things he just wants to give you because he loves you. And the entrepreneurial thing is because he loves you. He just wants you to minister to people in your gifts. And he wants you to do it. You help everybody around you. And he's ready for you to help yourself. So I just feel God wanting you to be very clear about your desires. And I understand it's going to take a couple of days for you to figure out what it is you really want. But God says, just tell him. He understands that you know boundaries in that realm. But he also wants you to know you can have some things that you want too. So he's waiting on you to share those things with him. God knows all. But he desires relationship for us. He's the king of communication.
Amen.
So spend time with him in that realm. And you spend time with him every day. But he wants to spend time talking about what you want this time. Mm-hmm. You pray for everybody and you never tell them that you're praying for them hardly ever. You pray for people who would probably cringe at the fact that you're praying for them. You pray for people who ask you to pray for them. You pray for people on your job. You pray for your manager. You pray for customers that tells you stories. Sometimes you talk to customers way too long when you could have made a sale, but you're ministering to them. You'll be in pain standing there ministering to them and not really taking your breaks on time or how you're supposed to take them. And you never told me any of this, have you?
Wow.
And you are literally doing these things, and you will go home with the burden of your clients on your heart. And God says, I approve, but I care about you too. And you feel that God takes care of me, but I need to pray for these people. But he wants you to have a balanced life. There are some areas in your life where you feel like you really just don't deserve to really ask for anything because God has been so good to you that you say, you know what, whatever he does, I'm all good. But God says sometimes he wants to know the particulars. For instance, and he's bringing this to my memories, and I do not know if this particular analogy has a personal, is personal to you, or is it just metaphoric for me to understand, but you would know. He's showing me 31 flavors. And he's showing that in that place is an ice cream parlor. But you can choose any flavor and any topping that you want, but you still walk out the door with ice cream. And what God wants you to understand is that I'm going to bless you. And I'm going to bless you in a specific area that you know I'm going to take care of you. But I would like to know the toppings and the flavor because that's your desire. It's like if you ask for a house, God wants to know how many rooms, what color, what neighborhood. He's going to give you a house, but he wants to know those things. And so what God wants to know with the areas that you already know he's going to take care of you in, He just wants to know what are the typings and what's the flavor. This is the word for your life. In the name of Jesus. Here's a word of warning, one more thing for you. And this is what the Lord told me to tell you. And I think he meant it in jest, but he was serious. And he said, you have the lost puppy syndrome. You bring lost puppies home. And he says, if you bring one more lost puppy home, he will make you open a shelter.
I get it. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes, that's done. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Terry, God is putting cushions around you. Have you ever, jumped on the bed before as a kid, and then you have pillows on the floor, and just in case you jump off the bed, you fall on the pillow?
Yeah.
So God says a lot of things that you're doing, you're fear of falling. But God says, I got cushions around you. So even if you fall, you won't hurt yourself, and you'll still be comfortable when you fall. And that's what the Lord is saying. The scripture is unto him who is able to keep us from falling. He wants you to know that you're covered and you're taken care of and that everything's going to be fine. And you know it, but he says he wants you to really root in it. And this is in so many areas. And I know you're private, but this is what he's telling me. And I pray that ministers to you in all the different specifics that you have.
Yeah.
Amen. God has not forgotten that one thing that you pray for a lot. He hasn't forgotten that, but you've got to believe him on the pillows, and then the thing will come. Okay? Amen. You guys keep praying. I still feel God speaking. Dana. Okay, the Lord says there'll be a financial increase coming, specifically a windfall. But God says you have to be a tither. You have to tithe faithfully. You save money, and somehow you attempt to save money, and somehow it flees. But he says you have to, with this windfall, make sure you become a tither. That says he will open up some windows of blessings in your household for your entire family if you do. Do you understand? It won't be just for you. It will be for your mom. Do you understand? It'll bring into some corrections, some things that has been a lack in your home. We've never talked about this, have we? Like I said, you have to be that person to put that into motion in your household, and you need to be faithful in it. And not sometimes, but faithful in the tithing. And God says he's going to show you, because you've really been desiring, and you may feel like people around you may feel like you travel a lot, but you desire to travel more. And God says he does not mind that for you. But he said, I will open up great windows of favor for you. He's just asking that you tithe. And that windfall is coming. And when that windfall comes, you are to tithe on that windfall. Amen?
Amen?
It's quite the windfall, by the way. It's quite the windfall. I pray protection over that windfall.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire in the blood of Jesus. I don't see timing per se, but it's not going to be long. Marcia, there are angels encamped around your entire family. And you have been feeling like guardian angels have been around you.
and specifically around your daughter. And it is what you think, okay? And it's a blessing, and then it'll bring your family great comfort. Some people don't believe like that. But God said it is what you think. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Keep praying, guys. Okay, Cherie. God said I can prophesy to you a little bit. It's about your ministry. Your ministry is going to go further than you think. And it'll be at your speed. And that speed will change over the seasons of your life. Sometimes fast and sometimes slow. It's just whatever you need. God says you will have rule over that thermostat. You can move that fast or you can move it slow. You understand? And it won't be hard. People won't understand because they'll know your testimony and they'll say, okay. You say, I can't come this time for this, put me down for next year. And they'll say, oh, you were busy, you can't come. You say, I'm a survivor of this, so I need to keep up with my health. And they'll say, oh, I understand. And you say, survivor of this. You do not say, I haven't. Even so, you say, I'm a survivor of this.
Amen.
And you will encourage everyone,
yes, Jesus,
with diagnoses like yours, because they'll say, I'm a survivor of mental illness.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
And there'll be such a movement of encouragement. It will be such a movement of people encouraged, from the young to the seasoned. You will have t-shirts that will say, I am a survivor.
Amen.
Of mental illness. You will say, shirts, I am a spouse of a survivor of mental illness. Don't forget, such a movement. Your ministry is a movement, and the travel will be in the ministry. You will vacation at times. But it will be in the ministry. And it'll go as fast as you like and as slow as you like. And it will be well. God said he's going to make your name great.
Amen. Amen.
You will not have a ministry like anyone you know. Because it will be like yours. It will have your flair. And sometimes you won't preach. Sometimes you'll just be a really, like, you'll be a speaker, a motivational speaker.
Yeah.
And you'll go and be inspiration everywhere, even when you go to schools. Mm-hmm. You will talk about God like you was at a church, and they will accept it.
Amen.
So you'll say, I preach everywhere. And it will be well, and there will be people who are Muslim and Buddhist and atheists that will be inspired by your message.
Amen. Amen.
And you will hug people that you meet all the time, and they will come to you and say, well, can you hug me? And you say, sure. And it'll be great. It'll be a warm movement. just full of warmth and healing and encouraging. You will encourage a lot of parents. You will. And there will always be somebody who tell you, don't you say that. And then you just know that your ministry's not for them.
Right.
You know? And that's okay. Some places, they'll celebrate you. And some, they'll be afraid. And you understand the stigma. And you understand the stigma will be more on a motivational level. But the blessings are just going to be so much greater. So don't focus on what people say to you, because there will be rude people everywhere.
Yeah.
And sometimes it will hurt your feelings. But you can't let that take you out. You understand?
Yeah.
If you need to take a break, take a break. And then when it's time to come back, come back. And when they ask where you've been, I had to take a mental health break.
Amen.
But I'm fine and well, thank you. Okay? And that's all they need to know. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you.
Yes, Lord.
God says, stop telling people you want to be an advocate. You already are.
Amen.
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 You already are. You're just looking for a place that will benefit from your advocacy.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
I have a word for the future for you. When you get married, you're going to have 3 children. Daughter first, then 2 boys. Amen. You've been wondering about your future in that way. That's your answer. Amen. The daughter will have a lot of hair on you. Philip, God wants you to know something. God says there's healing for you.
Yes.
Yes.
He's clearing out the path where you were unsure where to go, and he's moving things out the way so you can really see clear what to do. It's okay to be cautious, but God's going to make himself very plain to you. You're safe in his hand in every way. And you've accepted a lot of things that you have struggled with, even recently. Even in areas of family, you've accepted some things. And God wanted that to happen so that your burden could be lifted. God says, the enemy will test you in your peace. So you have to protect it. No matter what, protect your peace. God says your peace is the key to your prosperity.
Amen.
When you're not peaceful, you're not prosperous. Protect your peace. God said, I'm opening up new doors for you, son. And these doors our light burden. And he said the yokes will be easy, the burdens will be light on these doors. And he said it'll be so many opportunities. He said he'll give you 1 year to make a decision on those opportunities. Then you can choose which one you want to do. Do you understand? God's opening you up into different areas of employment. And you'll have a year to decide what area you want to be in, what department you want to be in. Do you understand? And it's going to be fun, God says. And you're going to meet a lot of people. And it's going to give you a sense of purpose and control. And God says it's time to step up in your bike riding. He wants you to start going to contests and riding.
Amen.
God says you're a trophy winner. He wants you to be very serious about this. You're a trophy winner. Amen. There's an anointing on you, Philip, that when you walk around properties, you can pray protection over them. God says operate in your anointing, especially when we move. Amen. In Jesus' name, that's the word for your life. Amen. One last person, and then I'll be done. Maurice. There's a raise coming for you on your employment. Did you know that? Yeah. I don't know if it's going to be this year.
Okay.
It might be next year. Okay. But it's coming.
Okay. Amen.
It's not a lot, but it's coming.
Amen.
You'll think of it as a step closer to your goals.
Okay.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. God wants you to persevere in your education more. Yeah. There's fear there.
Yeah.
You don't want to do your homework. And God says you're going to have to do it.
Yeah.
But set yourself up with help, like tutors and stuff, if you need it.
Okay.
Amen.
Amen.
But he showed me that.
Yeah.
And there was a fear of homework there.
Yeah.
It was a fear that you will not be able to keep up with it.
Yeah.
But that's what part-time is for.
Okay.
Amen.
Amen.
And don't be pressured into doing more than you can.
Okay. Amen. I know what you're talking about.
Holy Ghost fire, the blood of Jesus. Lord, we just thank you for this word for everyone. We thank you, God, that this is an amazing word for your glory. We love you. We bless your name today. We forever give you all the glory. And Holy Ghost fire in the blood of Jesus on all this prophetic word that comes to pass exactly as I've said it, in the timing in which I've said it. In the name of Yehoshua, we pray, and everyone agreed and said amen.
Amen.
And may y'all clap for the Lord. At this time, we're going to take offering and then praise the Lord on the social media. We're on Facebook Live and Periscope today.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Facebook Live is helping us to have a second medium for the services when I preach, since the enemy likes to edit my sermons on Periscope. So hopefully it went well on Facebook Live.
It did.
Amen. Did you turn it off?
Right now.